and gentlemen. Addressing myself particularly to the ladies, may I call to your minds, their minds, what they have probably observed, that 98% of American men lose their singing voices in their adolescence. Usually, those voices are lost in bathrooms, yacht clubs, locker rooms of golf clubs, or latterly, in nightclubs. Personally, I always favored the shower. In 9 times out of 10, this doleful situation has been brought about by sweet Adeline, waiting for the Robert E. Lee, or I wonder who's kissing her now. And by the way, Harry Armstrong, who wrote Sweet Adeline, has received a mortal insult at the hands of a San Francisco man whom some of you know, who, within the last 24 hours, actually spoke of that great American production as Sweet Adelaide. Tonight, the reason for all this loss of vocal cords will become obvious to the fair sex in the 33 numbers that will appear on this program. Watch your men. They probably will use the remainder of the night after this great day of American music trying to get back the voices that they lost years ago. The San Francisco-Oakland Bridge and the ferries tonight will be a typical American amateur night of vocal discord. This afternoon, when I had the privilege of introducing Gene Buck, president of the American Society of Composers, Authors, and Producers, I apparently embarrassed him and his society in my words of welcome and appreciation. And he has asked me, therefore, not even to mention his name tonight, except to say that he is the master of ceremonies. I like to embarrass Gene Buck, if it is only to prove to the world that after his 40 years' experience on Broadway, he can still blush like a girl. So, Gene, now let me turn over to you these California people, who fortunately, by the way, got in, who are waiting for the greatest treat given of American music in any one place at any one time. Ladies and gentlemen, Gene Buck.
Right.